Together again, we're all about the liquor and the tasty gems. We would like to invite you in the silly minds we live in. Welcome to the show. Welcome to the show. Welcome to the show. Welcome to the show.
Oi!
Oi!
Hey, dude!
We're back!
Missed you.
Missed you.
Yep.
So, what happened to you, man?
Fucking, you know, spelunking.
You did?
Yep. And I'm terrified of heights, so.
Oh, you're being serious.
Yeah.
Oh, dude, shut the fuck up, dude. You went spelunk.
Yeah,
I was,
yeah. No, I've just been, you know, doing my thing.
You know, Chile?
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 Or Chile, like my goldfish that died?
Yeah.
No, okay.
Rest in peace.
Yeah, RIP. Jesse sent me a text message, was like, RIP, Chile. I stuck laughing, dude. It is kind of brutal. Did Chili ever?
Good,
did Chili ever pop up?
Nope.
Okay, so we know it went down the toilet.
Or the blue dog.
Oh yeah, well that's
yeah,
that's true.
The toilet or the blue dog.
Is there any way he wouldn't eat it if he had the chance?
No.
It's just instantly eat.
Yeah,
he would instantly eat it.
Fuck yeah.
Okay, just make sure. But I just wanted a quick shout out, Chili.
Cool, man. I appreciate that.
Jesse, he watched the episode.
Jesse, man.
He's feeling pretty bad about it. Welcome back, Taylor, to the program. There he
is. It's good to be back. Podcast world.
So Taylor has been out of commission because he's been a busy, busy baby making boy.
Yeah.
Yep.
And so Tay Tay, you had a baby.
I had a baby, and it was a little early. And so
how early?
Well, 32 weeks. So it's about eight weeks early. So the mom had a little bit of high blood pressure. So we went into the mom, Alex. That's what I'm used to that talk.
That's
about.
All
the
they
mom.
Say.
Yeah. The mom.
You are nothing.
Yeah.
By the way,
the mom.
They're like the dad back there fucking packing.
Crying.
Bags. And we're not, you know, we're not even married. So the baby doesn't even technically have my last name in the hospital. So it's like baby boy Ruben, which is cool.
All good.
It's not a big deal. He will. No. So yeah, baby came out a little early. Mom killed it. She was in labor for quite a long time.
Oh, she didn't kill it.
She didn't kill the baby. She killed, you know,
birthing.
She killed having a baby.
Having a baby.
Nice. Yeah. Okay, for a second there, I thought maybe she ate it like a
hamster.
Like a lioness.
She saw it and was like,
lions don't eat their kids, do they?
There's
the
gerbils for sure do, but yeah.
Okay.
There's a lot of infanticide that goes on in animals, like especially with like.
That's a new word.
Yeah, infanticide.
Right? Yeah, it's infanticide.
Ding. All right, so. Anyways, had the baby. They thought it was going to be a C-section, but she was able to do it the old-fashioned way.
How many hours?
I mean, total, I think it was like a whole 24-hour process, but the whole pushing thing was actually rather quick. Like, she got it out in like 2-3 pushes, but she was like sitting there for a while, dilating and all that jazz. And I got some good pictures with my nice camera.
Yes.
So I was in there snapping it up.
Lighting.
So
it's just like brings a crew in.
It's like, all right, guys,
come on, just make sure you wear your mask.
It's coming out
can
quick.
Can I get a bounce in the corner for?
Yeah.
boom.
You're in the shot.
Yeah.
Catch a fart. If she farts, catch it.
Any poop comes out, I want it zoomed in.
You zoom that in. You glaze it over. add a fucking glaze on there. Little post. Sorry.
That's
yummy.
So anyways, we had a baby Ty came out. Ty Baker Olette came out at 2:39 a.m. on Sunday morning, March 20th.
Wow.
The first day of spring.
The first day of spring. Is that lovely?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, my. And
he was a 3.9 pounds, came out kind of doing a little cry and stuff. And
good.
What did his head look like?
Well, no one fucking explained to me.
No one told.
No one told me that they come out, and I haven't taken a birthing class because, you know, whatever.
Well, you had 2 months. You were going to schedule it.
Yeah, maybe.
he did some YouTube searches.
Yeah.
No one told me that the baby's head was going to come out like a cone.
Some very
important information to tell a father.
Yeah, because you're like, well, that's a wrap on old
cone head there.
That's baby cone over.
Yeah. There's no brain actually in there, so just shove it back in.
So it comes out with a long cone head. I really immediately I'm like, oh fuck, he's a preemie. Like, maybe this is just, you know. And then my brain goes to, that's normal. It will go to normal. So I immediately kind of recorrected my horror and shock. But
good for you, man. Yeah. You know, you had that, like, it's cool.
It's cool. It's gonna work itself out. It did pretty quickly. Like, it does pretty quickly. And Richard was like, yeah, dude.
Yeah. Yeah, I would say when he told me, I was like, oh yeah, bro, for sure, dude.
He's like, do they tell you this?
It just made me laugh. Just made me laugh though.
A genuine scare that his kid was gonna be Dan Aykroyd.
Exactly. Is that where they got that idea too?
Probably. See, here's the thing, dude. I don't have any of those qualities. Like self-correcting, not a chance. Like if I didn't know what was going on, it would be chaos in the fucking birthing room.
So.
Delivery.
Steal a kid who doesn't have a cone head.
Just fucking throw it on the ground.
Oh.
Okay, sorry. Not really.
So he was born. They took him into NICU since he was little, and he's been in there about a week, and he's doing great. He doesn't have really any issues, just, you know, needs to learn how to swallow properly and all that.
Yeah.
Being fed through a tube.
Yeah, he's being fed through a tube, but he's been getting off all that stuff, and he'll hopefully have regular feeding, like bottle and breast. He's trying it out tomorrow, so we'll see. Nice.
That's lovely news.
All in all, he's great. He just came out early, you know.
Taylor's a dad.
Yeah.
You know what I was thinking about when I was pulling away after you told me about the cone head thing? I was like, I'll bet there is a little more skull growth that occurs definitely in the last like 8 weeks. That
the top, right?
No, well, the top stays open.
Right.
That you could fucking through the top of a baby's head and
drop. Take, yeah, lose your ring in there.
Yeah, until yeah. 18
there's like a
months.
Little. There's like a little soft spot. Right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. That doesn't go away for 18 months.
Right.
Until you can finally just get him right in the back of the fucking head with the ring.
I mean,
ring.
He's got a lot of little shape divot. Up. He's got a lot of little divots and stuff in there. Yeah, yeah, dude. So you can see it's still.
But like, I think so. The last 2 weeks, because Charlie was premature the same amount of time.
Yeah.
He came out. He was actually still 6 pounds somehow. So he was
solid.
He'd have been 25 pounds coming out of
there. Are you sure he was early, or they just fucked up his?
No, I'm sure. Because
is that a six or an eight?
The circumstances weren't good. Okay.
And Charlie's solid.
Oh yeah,
he's a solid human.
Yeah. That kid fucks other kids. but like, I think the last 2 months, a lot of growth happens. Like they double or even triple in size from the first 7 months leading up to it.
Yeah.
As the last 2 months, they grow a lot. So I'm sure a lot of the skull grows right there. So he had less skull to prevent the cone heading.
Yeah.
And so he was just a
my little conehead baby.
Your little conehead baby. Is it? It's all back to, oh, I seen it. Never mind.
Yeah, I posted. You wouldn't be seeing them Instagram photos, bro.
I'm kind of tight though.
No.
Well, from the pictures,
I would love
you
him just
think,
the same.
Of course.
From the pictures, you wouldn't think he came early or had a conehead. He looks totally healthy and normal.
He does.
In those pictures.
You know what's funny though? He doesn't have like a lot of baby fat on him. No. Like most babies come out, so his like arms are very skinny already, and his like hands look like normalist mini hands.
Yeah.
And because like he doesn't have any of that little baby fat that like, you know, they come out with. He's just like weird.
Like
and
cash app.
He'll get it.
Yeah. Sure.
Dude, the craziest hands are babies' hands and dead people's hands.
Yeah.
Equally weird.
For sure.
You remember cadavers, dude? Did you do HPA?
Yeah.
Did you go see the cadavies?
No.
You didn't do the cadavers?
No.
Oh, buddy.
No, we didn't go see the cadavies.
That's weird.
Cut
why?
That out
I don't know.
End.
We did the cats.
Yeah, so did we, dude. I pulled the spinal cord out, that bitch.
Did you skin it good?
Hell yeah, dude. I got extra points. What was our teacher's name? She was on Thule. Acid. Yes.
Yeah.
She was always like, ah! Like just always just like, okay, everyone. And I would always be like, God, you give me anxiety. What the fuck? You're too much.
It's all that formaldehyde, bro. Yeah.
Sniffing just formaldehyde. Shermy,
dude. Just scooping pigs out of the bucket.
Yeah.
Oh, you know what?
Having a lunch break, dip in the cig in the Sherman?
She was Sherman, yeah, dude. Yeah, for sure.
Sherman Merman.
Y'all smoke Sherm.
So yeah, dude, the cadaver hands. That's what made them human to me. Because they just looked like they were kind of
It was knuckle, skinny in between.
Yeah, and there was like 8 bodies, and we went and like some of them had like their skin taken off so you could see some of their like muscular structure.
Whoa.
But then like they left it on like hands, so like it just looked like an old man's hand, and that freaked me out. Dude, one of the tables they just fucking cross-sectioned a wiener right in half, so you actually got to see the three chambers of the wiener.
Oh, fucking Christ.
Wild. Yeah.
And they pump them full of fucking...
Because it's 2 big ones and then the little guy.
Mm-hmm.
The vein.
Mm-hmm.
The main vein.
That main vein.
Whoa.
Yeah, so we saw that. Oh, yikes. There was a...
real quick.
Yeah.
Did you cut the cord?
Oh, yeah, definitely. It took me 2 snips. I was embarrassed.
When you're talking about a wiener cut in half, I was like, oh, how that feels. Oh, it feels like the cord.
Yeah,
dude,
it took
sure.
me 2 snips. I was like a little embarrassed.
I remember.
I was like halfway, and then I had to.
Yeah.
Because I only.
And the scissors they give you are little.
Yeah.
The little angled one. Yeah.
Hook it up with some shears, baby.
Yeah.
I don't know. What are they fucking worried about? Like, I remember with June, they did the crossover, you know what I mean, where it flips and it just wedges the cord. Yeah,
it does
that thing. I was like,
yeah, that's kind of what happened.
Like, are these sharp or what?
It's almost like you got to do the tip first and then go through.
You got to get it started. Like
you got to know.
You got to get your pocket knife out and just fucking do that,
but dude.
We still have to do the circumcision and all that. I'm sure that'll come later.
The old
he's young
bris.
His little little.
That's.
I'm surprised Cam didn't say the moil.
Well, it is going to be a moil.
It's a moil.
Of course.
Right?
Yeah. Yeah.
I mean,
for sure.
We'll have a moil, I'm sure.
Yeah. Yeah.
Didn't you have a moil?
No. Just.
Oh. Who had a moil?
Their pediatrician was taught by the moil.
Oh.
Like, next best thing.
Yeah. He had so good.
We'll probably have a moil come in. They'll probably have a. Shake their snakes around or whatever these guys do.
Dude. They just come in and they pull their pants down and they do
copter.
And then they look at you and they go, "Excuse me, get yours out, Taylor. We're gonna.
You don't shake the snake as well.
Excuse me, Taylor."
That's how they dry the blood. They cut it and they just let the wiener out, and then they just get their wieners out. And they call it the moil dry, the dry moil.
Don't ever let the rabbi touch your schmeckle.
It's the moil coil.
and that's why they have those long. That's why they hold those for a little break.
I don't think those are Hasidic Jews.
Oh, okay, I don't know.
That's what it looks like.
It gives you something to hold on to. You're just like,
and now the chopper.
And they're like, "This is a new edition. Will we play? Put it on. Put the song
just
on."
Eating brisket too. Just fucking
snip here, snap here.
They're like, "Turn it on around the world, around the world." Do you remember that?
Yeah, dude.
I remember the first time I heard that song.
Well, like when the internet was really starting to fucking get its groove. I think it was like, it was probably Jeff King sent me a link, and you click on it and it's just a wiener going like this, and it counts every time the wiener goes around. It's got a little counter and you can't get it off. It's around the world. And it's going 3, 4, 5, 6. And they're like, I think Jeff might've walked in and been like, "How many times did you let that go around, dude?" How many? Like, let me see. It was like 240. It's like, you made it 240 wheels around
rotations.
Yeah. And I'm like, dude, you sent it to me.
Doesn't matter.
So I wanted to tell you this, Taylor. This is one thing that you have to look forward to as a parent. Mm-hmm. So today I get home, look through June's backpack. There is a little slip of paper that said that June did not complete an entire project that was due on the 21st of March.
Oh, yeah, I'm ready for this shit.
And I just go...
This is my life.
Whoa, I go, what the... what is this? She had a little slip of paper came home like a month and a half ago. It was about dogs and cats and a fucking a 4 or 5 paragraph long essay that had to be typed and all this shit. And we're like, what's this, June? And June's like, eh, it's nothing. And for some reason, we believed it. I don't know what happened. We made an error. And
it's nothing. Okay.
So not my style. Well, okay, I don't want to like throw my mom under the bus. She was really the one who navigates a lot of the homework situation because I'm doing work and whatever. So she helps me in that realm a lot, mostly. And so it slipped through the cracks.
Sure.
Came home. She got a 0 out of 100 on this thing. She has till Wednesday to make the project up. And so I took away her tablet for a week. And she had a play date or whatever with her best friend on this weekend. Fucking called it off.
Oh, shit.
Nice.
She's looking at me as I was telling her, like, this is, I wasn't like yelling or anything. I was
this is what's happening.
I go, this is, and I'm not good at punishments, dude. Like, I'm good at yelling and being scary. Right,
like, in the moment. Yeah.
Yes, but like, holding true to my punishments, I am failure it's after
hard.
Failure.
It's hard.
So this one, I'm just, and Kirsten, love her to death, man. She fucking calls me out on it. She's like, oh, well, good one, Dad. Like, because I'll be like,
right.
I'll be like, no ice cream. And then 5 minutes later, I'm like, go get some fucking ice cream.
Oh.
I love you. I love you.
Yeah.
And the kids are just like, got that fucking bitch on the
See, dude, I make a very good point to not do that. Like, I took Ruby to get ice cream the other night because Cash was fucking acting a fool, dude.
Oh, so you had to do the cream outside.
I did it.
You did cream outside the household.
Well, yeah, we went to the ice cream shop.
But did he know he missed out on it?
Yep.
Oh, okay.
Wait, how old's Cash now?
Two.
Two.
Yeah.
So he knows he missed out on it.
Oh, dude, we got back and Ruby's just
oh, yeah.
And Cash lost it. And, you know, trying to tell a 2-year-old, explain to him why he didn't get to go. Maybe it's a little young for that, but you know, you
Ruby,
start
with just like,
well, this sherbet's nice and like, yeah, you hear that?
For some reason, this is the best ice cream I've ever.
I think it's the best one they've done. Yeah, dude,
this is the best bet.
He's just like, ah!
And Ruby's 4 or 5.
Four. And I'm just like, dude, you know what, man? Like, I have to stay true to that. And it's hard. It's totally fucking hard.
Yeah, dude. It is. And honestly, like, I mean, I've held true. I've stood sturdy before.
Yeah, of course.
I've just been fucking up a lot lately. And a lot of times it's in front of Kirsten. She's the one who's finally like, they're never going to learn anything. Like, you are really doing bad at this. And so now I'm fucking holding tough.
Yeah, I'm not a pushover.
I'm not doing it anymore, dude. Like, all three of them have been punished in, like, the last week.
Is that because you didn't have to punish Ella as much? And you're just not used to...
I mean, that's a great point. And June never was a naughty girl until she got to a school where they actually required you to do work. You know what I mean?
Right.
She's just been fucking lollipop gilding her way through ANLC. Yeah. And then she,
and so then, it's true.
And then she got
it's true.
And then she got over here to this fucking charter school and they're like, no, we're not eating candy canes and biscuits for period 1 and 2.
I fucking knew it for all these years. I was like, these kids at ANLC, they're just fucking lollygagging. So
it's true.
Tanner fucking.
Dude, lollipop gilding her way through.
And so she got over here and they were like, for sure. Your guys' experience at Ingleside versus our experience at ANLC, very different.
Yeah.
I mean, we're still sitting at combined tables of 4. You know what I mean?
Oh, at lunch or in the
classroom.
You're still sitting with full pre. You know what I mean?
Kicking shins and shit.
Yeah. You didn't get your own desk.
Yeah. No. Never got our own desk.
It's like a preschool.
Yeah. So the very first time I had a desk was freshman year at Arcadia. And I was like, oh, I got my own space. I could put my book here. I was just like, oh, there's a lot of area under here. I'm just like, this is excellent.
Yeah.
Dude, we sat in blue chairs until we were in eighth grade.
The little plastic
chairs. Dude, I was eating my knees. I was eating knees while I was fucking learning little. Very little.
You did all right when you went to Arcadia, didn't you?
Yeah. And also, I learned really to like intimidate younger kids. That was helpful.
It made you feel...
No. Like, they'll let me cheat off them, you know? So
That's how I met your sister.
Yeah, there you go. Is that true?
Well, she was in my... Because I didn't know you first, really.
Right. No, I remember, yeah.
I was like, I still can't type for shit. But I was like, hey, can you type this? And we were in computer class together, and I just passed her my keyboard.
Oh, Anna was nice. Anna was down, a down bitch like that?
I kind of like... weasel my way,
yeah,
buttered her up a little bit,
like, and I'd be like, oh, just, you know, kind of do this, and like, she did it for a little, and then finally I think she like was just like, nah.
Taylor freshman year, he's hard to say no to. He's got that cute little face.
Yeah,
cute little face. And he's just like, mm-mm. And you're just like, all right.
Totally.
I can see my sister being like, eh, he's cute.
Yeah, he's a cute little guy.
She's like, you don't know my brother. I was like, no, who's this dweeb?
Who's this loser? And then I come over. Clowns, baby, clowns, baby, clown, clown, clown.
Whoa.
Sign this guy up.
Sign him.
Sign him. Get the fucking contract.
Get this guy a Gatorade.
I'm just like, I'm fucking in, dude.
Get this guy a Gatorade, dude.
No. Yeah, finally.
Yeah, you earned it.
I earned it. yeah, so that's always... Oh,
nice. So you have a day to do a month-long project.
So the project was a month and a half long of, right, like, little by little getting through these paragraphs and reading the stories and this and that. She read all the stories and she wrote all five paragraphs, and she's got beautiful cursive, which is wild. Like, the beginning of this year, she could like not read. She was a late bloomer. She's had a lot of learning challenges. But she fucking blasted through it. Now all she's got to do is take it to school. The teacher's going to edit it. It's going to bring it back. My mom's going to re-edit it because, you know, my mom's actually good.
Yeah, and get it through the...
Yeah.
Yeah, for
the
sure.
The different processes.
Yeah. Yes.
Precise. And then she's going to type it. I don't know how well June can type. I've never actually seen her type on a regular computer. She's pretty fast on a tablet.
But, dude, yeah, but the grammar is not there. You know?
No. And even Ella, who's like a star student, her text messages to me is just all... URs, like nothing is like really full sentences. It's a lot, right, of acronyms. The short,
yeah, but there's 20-year-olds that do that too.
I mean, I do
most
that
of them.
No, but I don't. I'm very prim.
I'll go. Me too.
I like to fucking make. I like to sound good, dude.
Half the time, I don't even look at what I'm typing.
I know, Taylor.
Before I send it, so
I know. Taylor send like two sentences that they don't even like. They don't, yeah, connect in any
dunk.
He's like telling me something, and then it's like, "Hey, Alex, get the fucking the shrimp cocktail sauce," and you're like, "Oh,
something we actually..."
That was voice to text.
He was like, "All right, yeah, I'll sure, be there at shrimp cocktail sauce."
And Taylor like, would look at it and be like, send that.
It's
anyway.
Fine. Yeah,
he'll get it.
He'll fucking figure it out, dude.
My friend told me he speaks my text messages language now.
Oh, really? Just
figure out what I'm talking about.
Yeah, you kind of gotta. I got a new tattoo.
Yeah, you did.
Shout out to Ursula. Fucking Ursula Tattooing. She, you can't see it that great, but
yes,
I did a cover up.
It's sick.
Little cover up of, you know, a tattoo that I have with somebody else that isn't my future wife.
Isn't it? Yeah.
So we got to get rid of it. It's still, dude, I had a lot of plasma do.
What is it, a green dildo?
Yeah, it's a big green, it's a
with eyes.
It's got, it's actually a three dildo. It's a thrill-do. It's a thrill. Going into a big butthole.
into a rainbow?
Yeah, dude, a big butthole, and this is pubic hair here. And this is the man's pubic hair down here.
Yeah, that agave pubie.
Yeah, that agave. And then this
super
is
gay.
This, yeah, and this is a big bull cock ring. So so that's cool, and that's that.
It's appropriate.
Yeah, it's appropriate, dude.
I love it.
You know me. I'm a big fucking
cock ring. And
those
colors
guy.
Are fucking
they're
sick.
They're vibrant.
Yeah, they're good.
Love it. There's going to be a couple more sessions.
Keep it clean and good so they last that long.
Oh, I'm going to.
Have you seen this new... not everybody uses it, but
the film.
Yeah, does she use that?
So she does use it, and usually you use it a lot of times with like very colorful tattoos.
Mm-hmm.
However, like I was saying, I was very I just lost the word. Plasma dewy.
Yeah.
So when you have too much plasma dew, which is like when you'd get a
pus.
It's like a watery substance that like comes to the top.
It's what's in blisters, right?
It's like blood water is what it is.
Yeah.
So anyways, if you have too much of that, it'll fill up that layer and it'll be like a huge like water bubble.
Oh.
Whereas like if you don't have that much going on, it'll just keep it covered and you leave it on there for like 2 or 3 days.
It's like Saran wrap, but
yes.
Improved.
She in fact gave me a Saran wrap and I was just, it was just like bleeding out both sides of it.
When did you get that?
I got this on Sunday.
No shit.
Yeah.
How you been drinking?
Looks fucking
drinking?
Good, dude.
I drank the night before.
That's probably why.
And she goes, that is why.
Yeah.
And I was like, there you go. Yeah, doggy.
Yeah, doggy.
Really? The coolest fucking thing. Shout out. She did a fucking fabulous job. Thank you, Ursula.
What's the shop?
I think it's just Ursula Tattoo. She has her own shop. She doesn't work for anybody right now. She's got her own little space. It's like an industrial apartment complex that is just for like artsy people. Oh, downstairs, nice. There's a painter, there's a photographer.
It's like a co-op. Yeah.
And it's downtown, like 15th Avenue and Roosevelt. So it's kind of like got a good little vibe happening right there.
Yeah.
And it's like people, you know, like wearing sandals and shit.
Oh,
you know,
Birkenstocks.
A lot of sandals.
Yeah.
You know,
barefoot. I've seen a couple
of
barefoot.
A lot of Birks.
Yeah.
Fucking beanies and cloves.
Dude, just rubbing, you know, arugula in your armpits.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
For the properties.
Got properties,
man. For the essential properties. It's arugula
in your armpits for the properties. Yeah, I know what you mean.
Yeah, it's got that vibe. There's actually another tattoo artist upstairs too. So she does hers, they do theirs, and it was really cool. Ended up she fucking cruised through it. She planned on doing it for 4 hours. It was like 2.5 hours.
Nice.
So really, and I put $100 down when we did the consultation.
Uh-huh.
So I brought an amount of money, a large sum, and I only had to use half of it. And not only did I have to use half of it, but $60 was also tip. So like I could have, tipping on tattoos.
Yeah.
I get it to a certain point. It's like, it's already a very expensive thing to get done, right?
Yep.
So just charge what you think it is worth. And like, no, like there should be no tip required. In my opinion. I did it. I've done it all my tattoos. I've tipped
them. Tell that to Steak 44. Tell that to fucking...
Yeah, but tattoo artists, for the most part, set their own price.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Some guys are really expensive. Some are more reasonable. And both can do good work. So if you're setting your price, there is no almanac for how to set your price.
Right, so, no. And I think right now, tips are... Like, 20 was standard.
20 bucks. Oh, on any tattoo?
20%.
Oh, 20%.
With anything.
Okay.
Ooh. Was standard, I think.
So, okay. Let's.
But now it's higher.
Let's dive into this because I Grubhub a lot.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And
the tip things.
The tip thing's weird on Grubhub. So, for instance, if I'm getting food from like 3 blocks away.
Yeah.
4 blocks away or whatever. I'm sorry, I'm lazy, but whatever. Getting it delivered to my house.
Oh, we don't care.
Do I need to tip you 20% on my $45 delivery order, which is going to be like 9, 10 bucks when you're only maybe putting in, I don't know. I think.
Yes, I'm feeling
7 to 8 is mm-hmm. like my, not like, and I think that's pretty high. And I was a delivery driver for a long time, so I'm like, I'll give you. So like 7 to 8 is like what I usually tip regardless of how much it is. But most orders are like $50 when you order for 2 people
on
Grubhub. So
here's the other thing. They fuck up a lot too.
Oh, absolutely.
DoorDash and Grubhub fuck up all the time.
It's like, so what are we doing? So here's, and by the way, Taylor, He was a delivery driver when you had to use maps.
Yep.
Okay.
Fucking Thomas guy.
Thomas guy, baby.
I told Alex that the other day, and she's like, "What's a Thomas guy?" I was like, "You're a my fucking... age, and you don't like."
She had a chauffeur. Okay,
who's Thomas? He's your guy?
Is he your chauffeur?
Yeah. You're like, Thomas.
I had one of those.
I had a Thomas, too.
His name was Daniel. I wanted to say Randall. That one, and then I know I've talked about this before, like Panera Bread, where they actually don't do anything, and yeah, they're looking for a tip.
2 weeks ago, Jess.
I'm like, who?
Yeah.
I'm like, who? I go, I wanted to be like, first of all, I tipped. I gave 20%.
Right.
Like but a fucking asshole.
I just give a dollar now.
But here's
for Grubhub? You
everything. No, no, oh, not for Grubhub. Like
you
for
didn't
all that
tip
shit.
For them. You tipped for you.
Yes. Just so
make
I could
you comfortable.
So yeah. I can survive the rest of the day. So I can eat the meal. Right. And by the way, I've only eaten at and I use Panera Bread. I always use Panera Bread as my example because I've only eaten there once.
Yeah.
And it was more expensive than I wanted it to really be.
Sure.
Just in general, it was like $17 for this like grilled steak sandwich.
Pretty basic.
And it was bad.
Steak and cheddar
cafeteria
sandwich.
Food.
Half of it was fat, like unchewable fat.
Oh.
I was like my very first bite, I was like very hungry. And when the very first bite squeaks between your teeth, ooh, and it's just like a piece of fat just went it's like straight up into my gum line.
Yeah.
And I was like, and then I tried to pull it and it was like the whole thing came out. I was like,
and then the bread's toast. Like,
oh yeah. Yeah. And so, and then I'm like, and I just, it was like a $22 meal. Right. And it wasn't even big.
See,
it was small.
See, here's the thing about that. You tip based on the service you get.
I'd like
but
to.
But you had to tip first before you even got the service.
Yep. And that's kind of what you're doing with Grubhub.
And that's what you're doing with Grubhub.
Because
you add it when you make the order.
You can tip after, but like then you're just going to forget. And then...
Yeah, and then you're a real asshole.
I feel like something comes up, too, where if you don't tip...
Then they take their time a little.
Well, I just feel like something comes up if you don't tip them right away that it doesn't show that.
Well, have you... I mean, you've seen now that like you have to put a tip in. Like, if you order online,
oh,
it's like,
you?
What's your tip?
Oh, yeah, yeah,
and
yeah.
You're
like 15's the lowest.
You're like, how about this? Here's
you can't check out until you do it.
It's like, here's the tip. Don't do this until you've delivered the proper meal.
Yeah, here's
you
your
send
tip.
That
the problem
tip.
Is,
here's your tip.
Which I was guilty of, like, after the fact, I forget.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then
it's
and
just,
like,
do you
like
think it's
because
COVID fucked everything up and now tips are just, like, mandatory? And, like, people are trying to make money or it's just an excuse? Or do you think that has anything to do with it? I don't know.
I don't know. COVID has fucked up so much shit.
But it wasn't like that 2 years ago.
Panera Bread was.
See, I get tipped at...
Was it?
Yes.
I get tipped at weddings as the DJ, which is, like, another kind of tattoo-type tip. Where
yes. So
you're already paying me. I don't need a tip or
your jar's not out there.
Like you tip me if you want to. It's usually like 10% too, only at that stuff. But the kind of
that is a very similar thing.
Yeah, because
you're setting your rate.
Yeah, I'm setting my rate. It's not like a different company like that's paying me, which I could understand. A lot of DJs have like a company they like hire from, but since it's mine, I'm getting that rate. I'm not expecting you to pay any more on top of that.
Yeah.
Right. So I don't
do
expect
you guys
it.
Tip Uber drivers?
From the airport, I do.
I've taken
that's only usually
because it's a little more of a pain in the butt.
I've taken zero Ubers.
Yeah. I'm just thankful. I'm thankful.
Zero.
For
I've taken zero Ubers.
Really?
Yeah, because when Uber got hot diggity
hot
damn.
Toddy.
When it got hot diggity damn, your boy was as clean as a whistle. So I didn't need it.
Just drove.
Right.
I just drove everywhere because I never drank anything.
Right.
But you never needed it to go on a trip or anything
to
like that?
Yeah, to not have a vehicle.
Oh, I haven't been on, like, other than going to, like, Carlsbad, like, I don't, like, need a drive to the airport because, like...
You didn't need a jet set to Jersey real quick for the thing?
It feels real cool when you get picked up by an Uber for the airport, dude. You
yeah, especially like if it's, like, one of those high-end Ubers or whatever.
That's what I usually, I try to get a little
a Suburban,
black
little
SUV.
Uber XL.
Yeah.
And then a fucking minivan shows up and you're like, wait a second.
I typically don't tip Uber drivers.
I...
You don't?
No.
Okay.
And I'm I tip know. Everyone.
I don't know what the etiquette is.
Like,
yeah, it's like, more of a airport yeah. special thing for me.
I used to. So
and that makes sense.
Tipping taxi drivers used to drive me nuts too, especially because, dude, back in the day when you're tipping based on like time or whatever, you're just sitting there and it's you're at a red light and it's just like the time is ticking, it's right. rolling, and you're like, that just cost me 75 cents to sit at that fucking light, dude.
Are taxis cheaper than
Corgale and the Boogie Brothers?
Dude, Corgale.
Can they be breaking in the ruples?
What was your question? Oh, are they cheaper than Ubers? I have no fucking idea.
Oh yeah,
what is an Uber?
Taking an Uber.
Yeah, what do they cost?
It varies. I mean, it's different.
Like from here to my house would probably be like $10.
Oh really?
Maybe yeah, 15 maybe.
Okay. Yeah, 10-12. I was gonna say 10-12 bucks maybe. Okay. Maybe 15.
Yeah, I feel
gas
like
gas is higher now.
But also, what's going on? They raise that shit up for.
I feel like taxis cost, if you went from Old Town to my house at 56th Street, like I feel like it was $17. 20, yeah.
$40.
Yeah.
$25
so
bucks.
I'm pretty yeah. sure taxis were more expensive somehow.
Well,
yeah.
They're competing. I haven't taken one in years. So.
Oh, they might have dropped their prices.
Yeah. You dude, barely. What was the last taxi?
222222?
I've seen them, dude.
Yeah, they're out there still.
They do. They're at the airport a lot.
Yeah,
shit like that. Where else have I seen them? I saw a bunch of them recently, and I was like, "Oh my god!"
Because
look at those dinosaurs.
One person that doesn't want to do the app on their phone,
yeah,
and just get in a taxi and just get the fuck home.
David from Azadi Rugs or whatever, he doesn't want to do it. He's old school, man.
It's funny when you get in an Uber and they're like, this isn't my real job, you know. Like, you've never been in an Uber, so you don't know. But they're like,
yeah, they try to talk to you about.
Yeah, they try to tell you about all sorts of stuff.
Actually getting into Bitcoin.
Yeah. Totally.
Oh, yeah.
I'm like, oh, okay.
I like when I get in, they're like, this is all I fucking do all day long, man.
Yeah.
Like, I almost have 900 rides today. I'm like, okay. He's like, I'm working for the bonus. I'm like, That's legit.
Yeah.
You're like, I would prefer you didn't talk to me.
Sometimes I get in the mood to talk. Like,
me too.
Yeah. Sometimes I'm like, fucking let's chat.
Sometimes I'll jump up front.
Really?
But sometimes I won't.
You throw
they
little,
don't like that.
Do you
for
throw
some
a little
reason.
Handy?
Oh, sometimes I do. Well, it's like if I'm getting picked up for the coach house, I'll hop up front for sure.
And you give a hand job.
What up?
Can you move your lunchbox over, dude? Yeah, I'm coming dude. In.
Yeah,
dude.
Move your big gulp. It's always a big gulp or a fucking Red Bull.
If it was my dad, he'd have a gallon large thermos.
Of what?
Water.
Just water.
My dad would be like, I got my thermos. I keep that. He's like, windows down. I don't use the AC. Dude, my fucking house. If it's cold, it's fucking cold as shit in the house. If it's hot as fuck in the house. My dad, we keep that. We keep it. We don't use it.
What?
Yeah, I mean, he'll literally I'll walk.
He goes with the weather.
Yeah, he keeps it.
How many ACs do you have in this house, though?
Oh, we got
probably three, four. Or four.
Two, yeah. Two or three, maybe.
Yeah.
Nah, he'll drop it down every once in a while. I'll just fucking turn it. Like it'll be freezing cold downstairs in the middle of the winter. Like my kids are literally icicles hanging off the tips of their nose, and I'll fucking blast it to 85.
Oh jeez.
Because it'll shut off automatically. My dad has so many fail safes where like nothing can go too long.
He probably has a master fucking controller next to his bed.
Yeah, super old school though.
Richard. Those kids are fine.
Yeah.
Oh man.
Yeah,
the tipping thing's weird. I don't know. I just always do just so I know I'm good. And if you're gonna use someone over and over again, it's good that you keep a good rapport.
That is true.
That never happens with fucking Uber.
Not with
Grubhub
or Uber, no. But like my cleaning ladies,
yeah,
I tip them.
You got to tip them.
Yeah.
Some guy couldn't find our house the other night, and then he came and he was like from Grubhub, and he goes, "Oh, I've been here before, actually." Like, what the fuck?
Was he like?
What's your problem?
He was like the guy from Home Alone 2. He was just like, and you just gave him a couple of.
I watched that.
Fruit stripe gum.
Fruit stripe gum.
We watched that in the hospital, actually.
I still have some tip from leftover.
Oh, is that Rob Schneider?
Yeah.
That's right.
Rob Schneider. And I think his name is Cedric. Oh. Doesn't he go, Cedric, don't count your tips in public?
Oh, is that...
Tim Curry.
Tim Curry.
Yeah.
I love him. Dude. So, my job, I wear a blue hat, a blue shirt. Get the blue hat.
Like what you're wearing just, right now.
Yeah, what the fuck? Oh, yeah.
This is what I wear.
Jay Leno fucking outfit.
No, so it's like a more blue hat and a more blue shirt.
Right, brighter blue.
And, you know, I have like black cargo pants. Got black cargo pants.
Dude, are they cargo pants?
Yeah. But they're more.
You got to keep your.
I got a wallet here and I keep my second phone here.
Oh.
And then I have a little. I got a utility knife here.
Okay.
It's lame, dude. But it comes. I need it so often where I'm not like near my car. I'm like, hold on a second. Just fucking open. I'm gonna get that screwdriver. I'm just gonna tighten up this sign real quick. It's hanging a little weird. But what I realized is if you walk, I can walk anywhere. I can go anywhere I want. I can go into any building I want if I just walk with authority.
Yeah.
And no one asks
totally
me. No one
confidence.
Asks, dude, yeah. You go in and you just fucking start looking around like you know what the fuck's going on.
Yeah.
You can go to the embassy.
Dude.
Embassy is what I was going to say. You can go anywhere you want. You can go to fucking City Hall. Walk in there right now with a blue shirt and a blue fucking hat.
Yeah.
And just tell the fucking security guards to fuck off.
Or, you know what the move is? You go into a place and pretend you're on the phone and point at shit.
Yes.
Dude, like, no one will fucking stop you.
Just like pointing at surveillance.
Yeah, like, oh, the girders, yeah. Fucking whatever. Like, dude, no one will stop it. They'll be like, oh, he's official. Yeah.
Do you get funny? That? Do you get that?
Yes. And you know what? That's how Anthony got away with stealing so much shit.
That's true.
Was just
walking.
Yeah, walking in there with authority, like, fucking, you know, just
and then just walking out,
yeah,
with four 30 packs of Coors Light,
yeah,
yeah.
Oh, I'm on my way. Yep, I'm sorry, I'm late. Poor guy's late. Oh,
yeah,
you know?
He's got to go.
Yeah, he's got to go.
Let him out.
Yeah.
So I think I'm gonna just start just doing it on my off time.
Just walking into places.
Just going into places. Just checking things out. Yeah. Maybe going to a museum. Just like go behind ropes and stuff and just be like, just looking around, you know, it's like a $1 million thing. I'll just be like, yeah, it's got a chip, you know, and just if anyone gets near me and be like, hey, fucking bag off.
Yeah.
This is my domain here.
Yeah.
And they're like, who are you? I'm like, fuck.
And you think that your work outfit is the costume for
just a lot of stuff
for it. You got cargo pants, bro.
I got cargo pants, dude.
The utility knife is what really does it.
Yeah, dude. I'm just like, I'm touching it. I'm like,
is it in an exterior sheath or is it in your pocket?
It's an exterior sheath.
Okay.
It's hooked to
everything.
It's hooked to my belt.
Yeah.
It weighs my pants down. I don't like it.
What?
A little bit. It's heavy. It's a Leatherman's.
Yeah, those are dope.
Yeah, they're nice.
Those are good things to have.
Got it on Amazon. You know what I mean?
So you're like, I'm going to go just start doing that.
You know what? Here's how I realized it. Because I know that's like, people know that to be like a thing, right? I'm not saying we're not saying anything fucking crazy.
New,
like,
yeah.
This is old news. But what I realized is that when I am going into places where you do need some sort of like authority, like I have all the codes to a lot of places and shit too.
Yeah.
So it's like if you were somehow to manage being able to like just by knock a fucking, you know, somebody logging in the code and then just you knew that. So it's not like it doesn't. If you know the code, it's not for sure, dude. It's not for sure. Somebody could be by knocking, dude.
Right.
Nearby and checking out your little codes because no one's fucking covering up their, you know, they're just blasting codes out there freely. No one, dude.
No one.
Even when it tells you to do it at fucking Circle K. I'm like, I can't even.
Or the ATM machine.
Yeah. I'm like, dude, the sun is so bright, dude. I can't see what's going on anyways. What am I going to. I just fuck all that, dude. But sometimes when people get really close to me, like the supermarket.
Dude, I'll fucking
extend my shoulder blades out a little bit.
Oh.
I'll extend them out, dude.
You got big, good shoulders.
I'm just like, what the fuck, dude?
Talking about going into places with authority, we're doing a job at the Red Bull canning facility for North America.
Wow.
Is in Waddell.
Oh,
303 in Peoria.
Okay, I've been there.
Fucking crazy shit.
Is it cool? They have half pipes.
It's super impressive.
They have half pipes in a fucking Olympic pool.
They could.
Do they? Though?
It's just acres of one building. the building is acres giant, and the towers of Red Bull and Truly are fucking...
Oh, they're made by the same company?
It's the canning facility. Like, it's all just, that's where they can't in the shit. Like, like, the conveyor belt that does this with the cans.
Yeah.
And then it goes into the box and it goes, and the boxes come out full.
Yeah.
Like, times, like, a million.
Yeah.
So, we're doing a little job in there, and, dude, it's so impressive. And, like, they have this pit where it's, like, if a can is mislabeled... or something, garbage.
Just in the
garbage. And it's something like 10,000 gallons a day.
Of Red Bull?
Yep.
And Truly?
Gone.
Oh, that's the waste?
Yeah,
oh,
they, dude.
That's calculated fucking, into the old...
It's that exponential how many cans.
Where is that going? What
America, North America?
No, but like, where's the busted can?
I can't say.
It just goes into a hole.
A drain.
Yeah, does it go to the center of the earth?
Yeah.
Jesus Christ!
It goes to the center of the
earth. That's actually what's powering the planet.
Yeah, it actually just gets siphoned to the fucking power plant. Yeah. They just it's just basically.
Dude, it's just Red Bull. It's just siphoned.
They don't recycle those cans.
They crush them into these bricks.
Yeah. Oh, okay. And they send them off to the old. Yep. What is that? A goddamn
recycler?
The shredder or whatever. But, dude, it's one of those places where you walk in and you're like, what the fuck?
This exists?
Yeah.
And it's the one that distributes to America. Like, that much Red Bull. It's kind of gross, really.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
When you see how much shit is being made and, like, the vats that are, like, 50 feet tall.
Silo.
And it's just... Red Bull in there and syrup and fucking these big things of syrup.
Does it smell like crazy Red Bull?
I come home and
yeah,
it smells like Red Bull, dude.
Ugh.
Yeah, it's gnarly.
I kind of like
it's super gnarly, but it's super impressive.
It is. The very first time I went into the Shamrock facility where it's just like thousands of conveyor belts shooting different products all over the fucking place. You're like, damn, that's wild. But then it'll get like stuck in like a transitional track.
Right.
And just fucking...
It jams up.
And hairy, fat, fucking, like, Lloyd has, like, just a fucking... Lloyd. A pool, like, one of those pool skimming things. And he's just, like... His shirt's too short.
So, yeah.
It's like, and his belly's hanging out, and he's just, like, poking the box. And then when you stare at that, you're like... It's not that magical, really. You know what I mean? You're just like, Lloyd's over here. He's like, poker.
Like, you look at all the equipment and machinery, and like you look at Echo Canyon and all those ridiculous houses up there. You're like, who the fuck are they? Yeah. They're the ones who like patented the fucking machine that does all that. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, that's major. It's just, I don't know.
A guy was like, you know what? I am sick and tired of licking envelopes. They should just put a little sticker thing on there, for goddamn it. And he saw that one infomercial where the fucking caveman is chiseling the wheel, you know, that you see at 2 a.m.
Yeah.
Like, you got an idea? He's like, yeah!
Yeah.
I sure fucking do.
Yep.
He's like, my tongue is numb.
Yeah.
And he just calls down there. They're like, hey, wheel chipping away place. And they're like... you got an idea? He's like, yeah, motherfucker.
Yeah.
Drop the contracts. I got escrow going down at fucking Echo Canyon.
It's crazy. It's fucking, it's crazy. Yeah. Who thinks of these things? Machines, dude. It's fucking amazing.
Mayo must, dude. I thought of it. I fucking knew it. I should have called the fucking Chipaway Wheel Place. Didn't. Next year, on the shelf. On the fucking
What's it called?
Mayonnaise mustard.
Not as good.
And I had a cool fucking name, Mayo Must. God. That's the brand you trust. It's the brand you trust. Spread a little at Mayo Must.
Spread a little love with Mayo Must.
And then it's just...
Yeah, and French's would have fucking paid you handsomely.
I would have been... Dude, I had a fucking...
Is that what French's is?
French's is like... You know, like mustard and...
Mayo.
Yeah, French's.
Or Heinz, you know? One of those guys would have picked you up.
Yeah, man.
I'm a spoiled
little bitch.
Yeah, Sir Kensington's.
Oh, Sir Kensington.
Yeah, so I'm buying the Sir Kensington.
Yeah. What are you paying for? What are you paying?
Well, you know the special sauce.
Is it a glass jar?
No, no, squeeze plastic. You know.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
Save the environment, dog.
Have you ever had it?
No, I don't even know what you're talking about, but it does sound very.
It's just like pretentious fucking sauce.
Is it Poupon?
Well,
is it better than Poupon?
It's apples and oranges. I haven't had Sir Kensington's Dijon. Because as far as I'm concerned, Grey Poupon is the Dijon.
It's got that market.
Yeah.
He's got that market on lockdown. Yeah, dude.
You can't touch that shit.
No, dude.
That's it. That's the real deal.
That's the real Glockenspiel.
But no, it's like, it's this fucking $6 a bottle sauce, you know?
Oh, it's just a special sauce.
Yeah.
It's like,
I don't get the ketchup or the mustard because it's like, that's ketchup and mustard. That's way too much to spend for that.
Yeah.
But it's like a special sauce, like In-N-Out. You know.
Okay.
It's kind of like in a thousand
islands. Sir Kensington.
It's Sir Kensington.
Yeah.
Dude, it's fucking the Beatles.
It's real blue.
Does it have any little
pickles?
Little picky dickies?
Yeah, it sure does.
Dude, you can get this is the greatest thing of all time. I found out my girlfriend's got it. It's the fucking the Chick-fil-A sauce comes in a little.
You can get it in the market.
That. Dude, you can get it at the market and it is it's fucking fine price.
Dude, Chick-fil-A?
Not a fan?
Just not that. It's not fucking back up 3 miles good.
No.
I mean, you know what I mean?
It's pretty good.
It's pretty good. It's kind of basic, though.
Well, here's the thing, though, dude.
It's kind of a basic chicken sandwich.
Ah. It just has something that I like.
Yeah.
Here's the thing. You know what I really like about it? Let me just tell you.
Yeah.
Because that's why we're here.
Yeah.
They actually get through the line fast.
Yeah, they do.
So there is a line, but you could sit at McDonald's line.
They pre-make all those sandwiches.
Yeah. So they're just ready to go.
Right. Right. Yeah. I got a cold one once.
But okay. Well, that sucks. But like, if you're pumping so much, it'll never be cold.
I just.
You got a cold one?
Yeah, I don't.
Dude, come on.
Sounds like.
Where'd you go? You're just going to this one over here.
It was in Surprise.
Oh,
okay. That's fucking whack, dude.
It's not an Arcadia standard.
I'm not going to sit in there, dude. What?
It goes fast.
Hot and steamy over there.
Steamy. But they are steamy. You can tell they steam in the bag and they're kind of soft.
The bun's nice and soft, and that's cool.
Yeah.
I think the quality of the chicken is good.
Is it a good crispy chicken sandwich?
It's a good crispy chicken.
Is it crispy?
I did used to like Popeye's better, and then he just failed me so bad recently that I just can't ever go back.
It's like hit or miss.
It was literally like it was like a liver patty. You know how like liver is just like little tiny air bubbles?
Oh yeah.
Do you know what I mean? And like, you know how sometimes you'll get a chicken breast that's just like, it came from a mutant?
Yeah.
You're like, what happened to this fucking... Yeah.
Yeah,
so
chicken and like nugget.
And usually you can see like the grain like in these better places. You know what I mean?
That's how you know it's...
There's no grain. Good. And it was like... Eek. Yeah. It was like... And I was like, oh no, dude. And I powered through it.
Because you were starving.
And I just felt like shit, dude.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Extra shits. Big time.
Well, all right. I'll give Chick-fil-A another try.
Just give it a try.
What do you think of Cane's chicken sandwich?
Oh, it's incredible.
It's delicious.
Yeah. I don't like their bun, though. It's a big old bun, dude.
Too much bun.
It's too much bun.
Do you eat the toast with the box combo?
Yes. You know. Let me tell you what I do.
That coleslaw is good, too.
I'll do the coleslaw.
Yeah.
So what you...
The fries are soggy, but...
They're soggy. Yeah, dude.
We can do.
Who has the best fucking crinkle cruts?
I don't know.
Who's got the best crinkle cuts? Oh, White Castle. White Castle has the best crinkle cut fries in the game. Not only are they crispy and like light and airy and delicious, they're salted. They're very salty.
Yeah.
Which I respect.
Did you sit in that line too when that shit popped up?
I've only been there on off hour times.
Nice.
I've only... I didn't go until over a year of it's being there.
It's open 24/7?
No, I don't think so. But...
I feel like the OGs probably are, though.
Possibly. I'll just tell you that. Probably again!
Dude, Harold and Kumar.
There's a property called Ortho Arizona that's right by it. Did you go there?
Yeah.
That's where you went?
Yeah.
Oh my God.
For my fracture.
That's cute. Yeah. That's where you got your little bit.
Hannah used to work there.
No shit.
Yeah. She's okay. The one who's like, go to this person.
Very clean sweet. Property.
Yeah. Yeah.
And so I'm there early and I'm fucking do a quick inspection and it's right there. I'm like very first customer of the day. It's awesome. Dude, them fries are fucking riptard.
Dude, if you're the workers at White Castle and the first customer, you're like, hey, man, how stoked are you right now?
I'm like, you got four fucking
because I know you've been waiting a half hour easy. Oh, yeah.
All right, so this is a funny thing I want to tell you.
Tell me.
Okay, have you ever seen Freddy versus Jason or Jason versus Freddy?
Oh, fuck.
From like 2003 yeah, or something? Yeah,
probably.
Right, so... I didn't really remember it, but I did. I saw it like popped up on Netflix or whatever. And again, because Kirsten's in her life, I've allowed my kids to watch horribly graphic stuff.
That it's I all the curtains are down. It's all the ships have sailed.
It started.
They can watch whatever.
It started. No, they can't watch whatever. Like.
Not like pornographic, but if they're watching, like, if I remember, they're like killing each other for like an hour straight at the end of that movie, right?
Yes.
They're doing crazy shit to each other.
So where it's.
And they still don't die.
No, they never die.
Yeah, yeah.
At the very end, where Jason was clearly dead and Freddy had his head lopped off.
Yes.
And he had his own hand shoved through his chest.
Yeah.
So Jason shoved his arm through his chest, and then he fell back into the water dead. And then the very last scene, Jason is walking out of the water, which you're like, oh, so he's still alive.
Yeah.
With Freddy's head. Okay. And then Freddy's head winks at the
wink.
Fucking-
right. That's what it is.
No, awesome. But so if it's gore and or it's like it's a scary film, my kids can watch it. It all started this last Halloween. Kirsten would just be playing crazy shit, and I would be like, and Sonora was cool with it. So like her daughter was really cool, like okay with all of it. And she's like, yeah, just let him fucking watch it. Who gives a shit? And I was like, okay, whatever. And so it came on, and I was like, all right, Charlie, let's watch this. Because he knows who both of them are.
Yeah.
And a lot of it has to do with like stupid fucking YouTube videos that are like really poorly cut together clips and stuff. Like one clip will be very quiet. The next one will be super loud. So it's really annoying to sit next to anyone who's like listening to a YouTube video like that. Anyways, dude, getting off track here. So we're watching it. And right in the beginning, this chick's got great tits. And like I was like, oh,
yeah, all fuck. Horror film.
I was like, oh God! I was like, I try to fast through forward.
I was like, oh God!
And okay. Charlie's just sitting there next to me, and so I'm fast forward, and I get to this one part, and they're like really getting ready to start like fucking or whatever. So I start fast forwarding through it, and Charlie, he goes. Was that the part where you see his nuts? And that is how he referenced it to me. He's like, is that the part where you see his nuts? And I just started laughing so hard. And I was like, yeah. I go, that is the part you see his nuts. And you seen mine aplenty and you seen yours enough. Is it the part where you see his nuts?
Yeah, so he's figured it out.
He knows
he's got it. He knows what's going on.
I immediately wrote that down. I was like, Cam needs to know.
Gotta remember.
Yeah, because Cash is gonna do that to you.
Yeah.
And
for sure.
But we he
and
saw
now me.
Yeah.
Dude. It's...
And you see like tits in these things, and like there is no like they don't really care. Like they really it's not registering enough.
There's the window of time where they don't care and aren't registering it.
Ella blushes. Ella's like, I don't want to see this near my dad. You know?
Yeah.
Cause Ella has tits. Like she's a full blown woman now, basically.
Dude, I remember when I was young, not supposed to be watching Cinemax.
Oh yeah.
But like an Anna Nicole Smith movie was on, and my old man was passed out in the chair. And I was watching it, and I was like, this is pretty fucking rad.
Yeah.
And he woke up, and I instantly went, you know, fake sleep. But I kind of, like, opened my eye, and he, like, looked at me, and he looked at the TV, and, like, he was totally like, oh, fuck.
was I wonder if he was watching it or what happened here. And like, I think he turned it off and I was like, he went away. I was like, I dodged that bullet. Yeah, dodge that conversation.
The thing that's hard about that is like, I don't, how old were you? Would you say?
11 maybe. You
okay.
Know?
So therein lies the conundrum when it's your son.
Yeah.
And like, Anna Nicole Smith tits like are on the screen when you like come to real quick.
Fire.
And you look over, you're kind of like, is it really bad?
Yeah, like, was he like, he should be awake?
Yeah. I know my dad might have just like smacked me in the shoulder and been like, you should see that. And honestly, dude, Anna Nicole Smith might have been the first woman that was wildly out of proportion to what I thought was normal. Like, she was so wildly out of proportion that it was
it's like Jenny McCarthy was like, all right, that's wild, but Anna Nicole Smith was next level.
Yeah. And she was just like totally shaven down, like no hair really, her nip, like everything was like big tits, little nipples.
It's IMAX. It's going to the IMAX theater.
Big, like, big blonde hair, fake tan.
Yeah.
Nice feet. And you're like, I think that's what sort of ingrains, like, okay, now that's what I'm going to be into for the next 25 years. Yeah. It's almost fucked up.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like, because then you see Gummo, and you're like, I think I like that for the next 25
years. Oh, right. Right.
Do you remember that scene?
Yeah, dude.
With the girl?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes, I do.
Are you guys into the bedroom?
He's doing that. And what other movie was that guy in?
Oh, was he in Kids?
He was in something.
But again,
I'm like that guy.
That scene where he's just like grabbing her nipple and like shaking it like that. They had to film that, and they are
and keep a straight face.
Children.
Yeah, no, it's totally fucked up.
I don't know. Was the gal a child? Do we know?
I don't know.
Because their age kind of.
When did that movie come out? Like 1992.
The Red Hot Chili Peppers were doing really good at the time.
That's like when Funky Monks came out.
They were like hitting their fucking stride.
Yeah.
That was the one with the Down syndrome, right?
Yeah.
That's the scene we're talking about.
Right? Yeah.
Because there is another scene with a girl with the tape over her nipples.
Oh, right.
And that one.
That's rough.
That one didn't set the kink. It was the.
How has Gummo never been on Netflix? Or has it?
I don't think that is a good.
I think that needs to come. I think I need to check.
Prime probably has it.
Prime
has everything.
Prime's got it all, but you gotta pay. Netflix
probably will never have it, but like Peacock might.
I don't have it, dude. I don't have it.
We have Peacock because The Office is on Peacock.
Okay, so here's the thing, dude. You look up where is this thing streaming, and then you see, oh, it's not streaming anywhere, but it is on Prime. And you go, and then it costs money to fucking watch it. That's the thing. That's why Prime has everything. Because it doesn't come with Prime.
Fucking Netflix the other day was like, oh, you need to pay $5.99 more because there's multiple people on your...
Oh, you got it? You got the tax?
Yeah.
Yep, they're cracking down. They're cracking down.
You got 10 people using your Netflix account?
I mean, my parents use it, but I don't know who else. I don't think anybody else, but...
That's actually better than what...
I'm surprised it took that long.
They were originally going to... do something worse than that. Originally, they were going to do something like worse than that. You had to have one central hub. If it went anywhere else, it wouldn't work.
Huh.
Which is bullshit because if you go on vacation and you want to log into your fucking Netflix account, you know, and you're at an Airbnb, what do you do then?
They're going to start scanning your retinas.
Getting it,
fucking
dude.
It better be you,
dude. The Chinese man.
You're just gonna have to log out of your other home device and then log into that one with your pat. Yeah,
that's what it's gonna have to be because, or you're gonna have to pay. Is it your whole monthly thing went up? That's correct?
It's like $16.
Yeah, that's fucking bullshit. Like, first of all, they need to stop spending so much money on like a thousand
shitty content.
Yeah, dude, like the 1,000 shows that they're putting out, they're giving fucking specials to really dog shit comedians, and they're paying them well. Like, some of these guys get like $5 to $10 million per special. Some of them are not good. And I'll tell you this much right now, dude. I am all for the Asian community, but Ali Wong's last special to me was not good. What do you think?
Is she Raya the Last Dragon? Is she the one's like,
Yeah.
Okay.
She's that one.
Okay. She's the voice of the dragon.
Oh, no.
Zisu.
Not. I'm sorry.
No, not.
It's not her.
You know who I'm talking about.
Yeah, she's not a stand-up comedian. She's a comedic actress.
Okay.
I think her name's... God, what's her
fucking name? Ali Wong. I don't know.
Ali Wong is a stand-up comedian, and then she sort of went to, like, romantic comedies, and she's, like, really one of the most popular women comedians, for sure, but she's a top-tier comedian, like, on the circuit out there.
Mike Yeo's special's gotten, like, 20-something thousand hit or views already.
Nice.
When did it come out?
On the 17th. Oh, yeah. I'm shooting Angela Johnson special on the 8th.
Oh, so you already shot it, or I'm going to? Oh, you secured the contract?
Yeah.
Congratulations. So, where are you shooting it? Dude.
Tempe.
Improv?
Yeah. It's a little bit more of a...
Production
than...
Well, she's got a bigger budget. Right? Mm. A little bit bigger?
Yeah. I'm on an NDA.
Well, thanks for bringing it up.
Well, thanks for bringing it up.
I mean, numbers. I can't tell you, like, the fucking numbers. You know, my lawyer will be on my ass about this. And she listens to every podcast.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. No.
Can't have that.
Do you want to do Cam's Corner?
Yeah. I always want to do Cam's Corner.
Get out of here.
And then we'll wrap it up. That was quick and easy. We'll get out of here. Hey, Taylor, will you upload the audio version of the last one?
I already did.
It didn't go up.
Look, I swear I put...
I promise you, babe. Is this after we had talked about it the second time?
I think so, yeah.
Oh, okay. You think?
I mean, I don't...
Yeah.
I got a lot going on, bro.
Yeah, so our
what?
Last... Our
no,
yeah, we
no,
don't,
you don't.
The new one's not uploaded.
Are you sure? It's not even in the drafts?
I'll check again tonight. All right. Yeah, Cam's Corner. Let's head over. Yes, we actually have two pairs of headphones over there.
Oh, yeah.
And we have, I'll unmute this for you.
I'm going to refresh my.
What, you want to cut?
My little Vino.
Oh, we bring that over. I'll get this uploaded. Uploaded.
Yeah. Check 1, 2.
I can unmute that. Oh, is it muted? Taylor, what does this mean? Is yella? Check, check, check.
Why are you touching things that you're...
All I did was just hit that. Now it's muted?
No. Like, that's not the mic's on.
But I want this one.
Oh. You're like a child who walks in the middle of a movie and wants to know what's going on.
Main mix.
Oh, is that the headphone mix? Okay. There we go. Okay. Here you go, Cam.
Oh.
Grab a chair. Okay, Cameron, I have selected quite a few gems
right
here for you.
Okay.
Are you gonna sit
there? Yeah, I'm gonna sit here. I can see.
Okay. But people need to see you.
God damn. I need to fucking
Cameron.
I need to
grab that chair.
I need to chill out. I need to go on a diet.
Maybe too.
I've been trying.
Here we go.
Yeah, dude, honestly, that's where I had the most success. Competitiveness.
Yeah, me too. Of course. Okay, so I don't remember this. I've been accumulating these over the last... put those on. Over the last 2 weeks. And so most of these I don't remember, which is gonna make it more fun.
Okay.
And this is where I would highly recommend you hopping on the YouTube channel. Because you can't see, but if you're listening, hey, use your imagination. Okay, And oh, cool, Richard, love it. Now this is the
balloon's wild.
This is TV magic. Is it number four? Let me just make sure. Yeah. Okay.
I can't believe you've never taken an Uber.
Yeah, I know. Here, are you ready for your first video?
Yeah. Oh my god, if that was the video.
What's pulling? Oh, no, it's nothing.
Okay. Oh, nothing. I'm just.
Okay, okay. Ready? And here's video number one for you.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
That volume at halfway on the computer.
Oh my god.
Oh, is that too loud?
Something about when you're the back of your head and your neck hits the ground.
Yeah, so
I forget what the move used to be. The Razor's Edge. Razor Ramon.
Here's the thing. This never had a chance. That's what I noticed right, about this. Look, it was the very first one. Way off.
Dude, so there's somebody to tell you about, your buddy Cam. I used to be able to do those flawlessly.
Those little back handsprings?
I think they're called round-offs.
No, that's a round-off?
Yeah. When you do like the... Yeah.
No, oh! It's a round off into a back handspring.
Into a back handspring, yeah, but yeah. No, he wasn't even. Dude. You hear the. Here, do it one more time because the impact of the head is, I just heard it.
Is massive.
Just heard it.
Yeah. Here, check it. Oh my god.
Dude.
He did. He died.
He did.
Okay, so that one's good.
What an idiot.
All right, what's next? Yeah, what was his deal? Okay, you're going to like this, Cam.
Nice.
You're going to really enjoy this one. You ready? Here we go.
Shrinkage like Peter Dinklage. So good, dude. Dude, that's like,
I know,
but like, better, dude. Oh, that man. Sounded really good. That shit's funny.
Yeah.
I watched a little Ralphie May clip earlier today. How he's talking about Brad Williams. He's like, yeah, never go drinking with Brad Williams. He'll pull up to the bar and drink a bunch of thimbles full of whiskey and like all this shit. I'm like,
thimbles.
And the only reason I watch is because, you know, Bert telling that story about how he would like how he bought Ralphie made dinner and he didn't have enough money to do it or whatever. Mm-mm. Oh, you should watch it. It's on Rogan.
Okay.
He's like, Ralphie May always used to fucking, because Bert was on tour with him and he opened for him. And Ralphie would always buy dinner for him. And one night he was like, I'm doing it. They were like in the Bahamas or something. And Ralphie fucking orders like, his order is four meals.
Yeah, yeah. It's
and wild. So like, it's like, oh, it's like $1,500 and like Bert didn't have the money in his account, but they still went for it. And like his wife's bitching at him. And he's like, yeah, Ralphie just came up to me and went, it's all good, player. We'll get it back in roulette, you know, or whatever. Oh, yeah, yeah, dude, it's super funny.
I've seen that. Will you grab me?
Oh, yeah, shit. Sorry. I should have brought it over. That was fail.
I'm sorry. Failure. Check one, two. We'll get right back to it. So for those of you who are just listening, the last one was a little person getting into a car, and he's acting very badass.
Yeah.
And then they cut scene to a little RC car driving.
Can you tell me who sings that song?
Can I hear it? It's
Bad to the Bone.
Is it the same band, the same people who do Pusher Man?
It's like something, it's a guy's name.
Yep, that's true.
Oh.
George Thorogood and the, sure, yeah. Yeah, and the Destroyers? Yeah.
Oh boy.
Good job, guys.
Okay, you ready for the next one? I think you'll like
this. I don't know.
I think you'll like this one a lot, actually.
Oh my.
Dude, what?
Dude,
what?
What are you?
What do you mean, what? How hard was that to watch? If you were in the building and you saw that happen, what would you do? The same thing you did with that old man who fucking passed out?
Yeah, dude.
Dude.
It's like, how do they not know that's a possibility?
Get in where you fit in. That's crazy.
Hey, listen, he went for it, dude.
He did. He did go for it.
Kudos, dude.
And you know what? He just got reminded not to ever try anything.
Yeah. That's a solid joke. And this one, I don't remember at all. I have a little people thing. Huh?
Yeah, I like it.
My bad. Let's watch it again. Come on, here he is.
Oh, go!
Look how he's trying to run so fast. But here's the thing, dude. It's like,
can you imagine being his friend? Like,
they get to fuck with each other, which is
sorry, Leo or whatever. I don't know.
Here's what I am.
Was he trying?
I'm gonna say, you don't need to catch yourself with your face. You could put your arms out. You're a little
person.
The fact that he literally tried to break his fall with his own face.
Fell in a little pool.
Okay, I gotta sort of set this one up a little bit. So on TikTok and Reels and stuff, there will be like a woman and be like, okay, this is just for the ladies. So if you're a man, keep scrolling.
Right.
Rarely do like guys ever do that. It's usually women being like, this one's for the ladies, so if you're not a lady, keep scrolling. Well, this guy, he's doing the, this is only for the dudes, you know, keep scrolling kind of thing. And Ryan from Instagram, the photographer who takes some really great scenic shots of cactuses, in fact. Maybe I'll use one of his pictures to like put another cactus on me. I don't know. But he always sends us Reels to put on Cam's Corner, and I selected this one.
Nice.
And this is from Ryan, so shout out Ryan from Instagram. We appreciate your support, bud. So and that sounded super insincere, and I didn't mean it to be.
I'm being
sincere. Okay, so, and we're gonna watch it all the way. This one's kind of a long one. It's 38 seconds, but you'll like it.
All right, this video is for the boys only, so if you're not a boy, keep on scrolling. I'm just looking for some advice on my PC setup. Looking pretty clean right now. Now that it's just the boys, I need some help reframing my door frame. It's been like this for a couple weeks now, and I just need to know when I start. All right, now that it's really just the goddamn boys, who's going to help me rank the these goddamn games? Boys. These are probably the best games I have for the PS4 right now. And
dude,
now it's really just the motherfucking boys, all right? Who's going to help me pick what I'm going to drink this weekend? We got High Noon, we got Corona Premiere. All right, now that I've confirmed it's just the boys, how do you shave your butthole? I'm assuming you have to have a second person involved, but I don't trust anyone like that at this point in my life. I just need...
And it ends there. I don't trust anyone at this point.
Would you? You would. You don't need to because you did it yourself.
Dude, I used to just hover over a mirror and shave away. Just because I wanted to get it licked. And this was like before I ever.
If a girl's willing to eat your butthole, she's probably willing to lick the hair.
Too. You're right. Well, this was 10 years ago I shaved my butthole for the first time.
Confucius said.
Dude, I got that from a fortune cookie.
It was like, if they're willing to eat your butthole, they're willing to lick the hair.
Yeah, the hair's not an issue.
All right, dude. Well, sometimes you get a little poo poo in the.
They're called dingleberries.
Dingleberries.
All right. Well, fucking. Yeah, and you regretted that one.
Yeah, you don't really have any reference for that particular vein of video, right? Now that it's just a motherfucking boy.
I liked that.
Yeah.
Okay. I liked that.
Okay. Well, this one, this guy, I really just truly love. He does a lot of videos on TikTok, and he's one of my favorite, okay? So just keep that in mind, because he's so fucking weird. All right, and let's get it going.
Go walking around through a parking lot collecting rare metals and see a mom, and you're just like, ha! And then you realize that it's your mom, and you're just like, ha! Well, can I borrow $20 to buy Super Smash Bros. And Wii at Funko Land? To the game shop, isn't that right? That's my mentor, and friend. Her name is David. And yes, she has a penis.
That's pretty good. That's pretty good.
And yes.
You know who he reminds me of? He reminds me of the guy who gets into his car and does all that weird shit and then goes, well, that was strange.
They do,
it's that kind of thing.
They're both really good at shit. Like that. Okay. I won't play that one again because it's kind of long, but he's one of my favorites. I forget what his name is. Oh, these are just classic. These are just classic good times. Here we go.
God damn, dude. Oh, shit. Okay, so he had to have clipped a love handle on that boulder when he fell.
Yes.
But damn titties.
Yeah. I like this scream right here. This one's good.
Nice.
That hurt.
Good job, Jacob.
Okay. So you like that one?
Yeah, it's good. It's good.
Okay.
I've probably done something similar to that.
Yeah, the thing is when there's a rock with
moss
on it,
yeah.
You know. I'm not even a woodsy guy and I know. You don't it's slippery.
Yeah.
You can't get any traction.
No.
Come on.
Come on.
Fucking noob, dude.
Even big titties.
Yeah, he has some shiggly titties.
I thought you were gonna say he had some shitty titties.
He's some shitty titties. That is so funny. Alright. On to the next. Here we go.
This looks like a skin thing.
I don't know.
Ugh. Oh. Dude, that was awesome.
Is it bro skin? Fucking... Oh, bro skedaddle.
He totally skedaddled. Look at this. Dude, I like that one a lot. How fucking gangster? Because, like, dude, that dog is a little fucking football that doesn't breathe good.
Nope.
You know, out of shape, but got down those steps like a fucking savage.
Dude, savage.
I want to say one more time. Play it one more time. Okay.
One more time.
Bro skedaddle.
Bro skedaddle.
Oh my God. That's good.
Oh, these
I
guys.
Like that one a lot.
Okay, you like that one?
Yeah.
These guys make me. I like these guys. These guys are fun. Ready?
I saw it! My wife asked me to stop singing Wonderwall. Guess what I said?
What?
I said maybe.
He always does something weird like that.
The slap. Yeah. Dude, and they're at work, right?
Yeah, they're at work.
So,
look at this slap.
What is he slapped down, though?
That's some concrete.
Oh, yeah. It's like a... Dude, he doesn't give a fuck.
That freaked me out.
That
was you? I didn't know if it was them or you.
He fucked up the precast mold.
Oh, this is cool, dude. Oh, yeah. I forgot I got this one. This one's dope, dude. You know Toxic by Britney Spears?
Nope.
No.
Don't you know that I'm toxic?
Yes.
Don't you know that I'm toxic?
No.
Okay.
Fuck. Is that going to fucking ruin it?
Well, this guy takes songs and he re-records them in an 80s style.
Okay.
So this is, dude, I'm not like a big Britney Spears fan, but this, I would listen to this song.
Let's take this song.
Have you heard that song?
Yeah, yeah. Yep.
And make it.
With the taste of your lips, I'm on a ride. Yeah, dude.
How good is that?
It's, Dude, that's like some David Bowie shit.
Yes, dude. And good, right? I like.
I mean, is it better?
Oh yeah, you don't think?
I think it is.
I think it is. This part I write.
I would probably rock.
I like this part, huh? With the taste of your lips, oh. I'm on a ride. Not that one. You're toxic, I'm slipping under. That part, because she doesn't do it in that rhythm pattern.
Right.
He does a different rhythm pattern right there that I like.
Yeah. With like the syllables and how he breaks it down. Yeah.
Is she okay. God damn it.
That's fucking really all good. I would listen to that all the time.
Yeah, dude. And his entire TikTok page. Fire. It's all good. Everything on there is good. Let's see what else we got. I don't.
It's already funny.
I don't know what the fuck this is, honestly.
It looks like a puppy pissed on one piece of bread and
what?
He ran out of mustard on the other.
Okay, well, I hope this is good. If I saved it, it had to be decent.
Oh, it was your peanut butter.
Peanut butter, bro? It's right there, bro.
Oh, yeah, dude.
Shit. Damn, I'm like, oh,
yeah, sure, bro? Yeah. What's wrong?
No, I'm good.
Peanut butter. I'm good. What you want, right?
Okay, okay.
Because he put his dick in it.
Yes, right there.
God damn, dude. It's too perfect, though.
Yeah, I know it is.
Yeah, he looks like he put like a shot glass in there or something.
It's what you want, right?
Damn,
I almost.
Wrong.
I almost have more of a problem with what's happening with the bread.
Oh, the mustard?
Like, what?
Yeah, what happened, dude?
What happened?
What are they doing? It was like he was trying to shake out the vinegar and it just.
Oh, yeah. Got that first.
Got that first burst. Yeah, dude. All right. Two more and then let's go home. You ready?
I feel, yeah.
Oh, this one's long, but I think you need to. Fucking,
nice. I need. How you pissed off is.
Look at this guy.
Les Grossman. Fucking.
Look at this.
And Tom Morello.
Look at
yeah, it looks like a yarmulke.
All right, here we go. Here you go.
Get the fuck out! Studio and rehearse. Maybe someday you'll learn. You suck! Don't clap a piece of shit. What the hell do you think you are?
Oh, he's a scary looking
person. You want to be honest? Anybody know who you are?
That's a man.
Maybe anybody else wants to enjoy the peace and quiet. This is one of the most important places in all of North America. Who are you?
Who are you?
Who are you?
That's
you
right.
Miserable, presumptuous, no talent. You're no artist. An artist respects the silence that serves as the foundation of creativity. You obviously don't have the talent. You don't have enough respect for yourself or other people or what it is to express yourself. In music or any other form of creativity.
Whoa.
NYU film school graduate.
I have to say, he has half lungs. He has half a body.
Yeah.
So the fact that he's able to pull off this level of like anger and like yelling, dude. You can tell he's like running out of a lot of breath.
Right.
And you're like, God damn, dude, you have a condition. You have
peck. Peck.
You have half a lung, dude.
You have a lung.
Let's see. We'll finish.
Okay. I had.
Oh, okay.
Dude, I kind of want to watch that again, though, because it's kind of long, but look at this fucking guy.
When you see...
I love how the guy just starts playing.
Yeah. But, like, when you look at it from this angle, it just looks like an old guy, and then as he starts to come...
He gets younger.
And it gets scarier.
Yeah.
Because you realize he's just a mutant.
Yeah.
He fucking fell into a vat.
Yeah.
Of, like...
If you're the family on Halloween that makes a haunted house in your garage for the kids to come through, hire that fucking guy.
That guy would be so, he would be so good.
Like, you're not an artist.
Oh, God, he'd be so good in a scary movie.
Yeah, dude. Yeah, look how scary that is.
He doesn't do anything.
What's great is that he starts playing when he's mid.
the damn piece of shit.
Oh, as he gets closer.
You any kind of artist? Anybody dude. Know who you are?
That guy's from New York as fuck, dude.
Enjoy the peace and quiet. This is one of the most important places in all of North America. Who are you?
And he who probably is rich, too, you know? For some reason, he's really good at his...
Dude, his outfit does not speak richness.
I think he's in Princess Bride. Doesn't he,
You don't have enough respect to yourself.
That's Willow.
When I said Peck, I was like, Peck!
In music, yeah. Really is a form of creativity.
Or...
And I'm an NYU film school graduate. Sucker.
Sucker!
I've earned my right to say it. Okay?
Okay.
What's in the bag? What's in the bag?
Little babies.
Just a little bag of babies?
Little bag of babies. Little mythical fucking babies.
Dude.
That's how he eats. He eats them for nourishment.
Here's the problem. He didn't make it onto Princess Bride.
No, he didn't.
He was in there.
Dick,
he showed up. Yeah, he can't control his...
He was like, where's the crap services?
You pretentious fucking...
I was supposed to have cheeses. You have to just like squeezes and cheeses. And they're like, hey.
Simply inconceivable.
They're like, we'll just get fucking...
We'll call you.
We'll get the famous guy to do it.
Yeah. Damn, dude. There was some uncomfortable stuff tonight.
Yeah.
And there was some super funny, cute stuff tonight.
We'll end it with a super funny, cute.
Okay.
Want to end it with a super funny, cute? Here it is. I think you like it. He's pretty good. Like he's doing real good, and just how? Like how did you? You were
you come into that with so much confidence and speed, and just fucking lose it.
I mean, look at this. Dude.
It's Wayne Static.
He didn't even. Dude, look at. He's very confident. It's like, give up immediately, dude. His bike went further than he
did. And what was his plan, dude? Where was he going? There's a fence and a river, dude.
Maybe that's what he realized.
He's like, oh, wait.
I actually don't know what I'm doing. Fucking idiot.
Dude, I love this because I don't see a lot of stuff anymore.
Yeah, this is good.
So you're keeping me fresh and privy to the...
To the loop. All right, well, that's
fucking pretentious.
And I've earned my right to say it.
I know. No, it's like, dude, your belt is around your torso. Yeah. If you loosen your belt, you'll breathe better.
Yeah, like, what's with the Boogie Nights collar, dude? Take it easy with the Boogie Nights.
Literally went through his belt.
I know, dude.
And that blue.
And it was like, they were out here, dude. They're bat wings.
Tony Stark. Fucking, yeah.
That's it.
That was a good one. I liked it.
Good episode.
It was fun. Oh, yeah. We're done. We'll just do it now.
Yeah, we're done.
Okay. Bye. Do an
earwax removal thing that has the camera on it.
Oh, I watched many of those. Where they pull up. Oh, I thought you meant like TikToks where there's a doctor and that's this whole TikTok.
Have you guys ever done it candling?
No, but I think I need to.
I don't
to.
Think that works. I got too much.
Those things that you can buy, I don't know if they work, but you can definitely go to.
I would go to a place where it's someone who does it.
They'll get it all out.
Fuck. I want to do it.
I'm going to find one and
just super red.
Put it on the show. All right, we're out of here, people.
Oh, you mean like an ear candling home kit, like our nostril thing? What you're going to want to do is put that in the microwave.
You just burn a candle, though, right?
And then make a funnel out of some paper, I think, and then like the suction. Yeah, the vortex.
All right. Well, thank you guys for watching another episode of the Dick and Booties podcast.
Those pants look fucking comfortable.
We'll see you guys next week.
Yeah, buddy.
Peace.
Peace.
Here's a thing where you spray.
Thank you.
Later.
Thank you. Thank you. We can't believe you stuck it out. We can't believe you had no doubt. Thank you for tuning in. We will see.